friend of mine asked me if I go through all this every time I take something to the foundry. And yeah, I do. I try to keep up on my latest knowledge as far as if the piece has been sitting for a couple of years. My knowledge has changed a little bit, so if I see something that isn't correct now, that wasn't correct then, but I didn't have the knowledge, I correct it. This neck was a little flat. It didn't really have the musculature that it should have had, and I've corrected that. And quite honestly, this piece wasn't done. I just got to a certain point. It didn't seem like it was ever going to get cast in bronze, so I kind of put it aside and decided to work on other things that could possibly be cast and other projects. But I'm really happy with how this is turning out, and I'm glad that it's finally going to get put in bronze, which is really the end product for all my clays. So, I just wanted to touch it up so that when it goes to the foundry, I have the best product possible. I don't show everything that I do on these videos. I reserve that for my instructional DVDs. I show enough to show you that I'm having a great time, and I try to give you a little bit of pointers, but the full extent of my knowledge is on my instructional DVDs, and therefore, you're just getting part of what I can do. this tool here, I have no idea where I got it from. It's got serrated edges all the way around the edge, which is really handy when you're trying to get into places. I've never had much use for straight edge things with serrated edges on because you can't get in the rounded corners or rounded areas with it very well. But you just work with it and do the best you can. I'm going to be taking this to the foundry on Tuesday. I was going to take it tomorrow, but I've got some people from out of town that are going to stop by and they want to see my studio. And they're only here for one day, so I'm going to have to be here for them tomorrow. Anyway, I'll take this to the foundry on Tuesday. I'll take the tools that I've been using only so that I can keep my current textures proper. I'm going to take some clay with me too, just in case I see something that needs to be touched up at the foundry under their light. Their light's going to be different than my light here, so it always pays. Pay to take an extra couple tools and clay. The last thing you want to do is have a different texture on part of the animal or the clothing or the blanket than what you got on the rest of it. All right, everybody. Have a great Sunday, and I'll see you next week. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.